Welcome to Life-Giving Water Messages, where I expound upon the Word of God and through the internet deliver it to you. Today is the conclusion of the message series Rock and Roll, entitled This House is Not for Sale, and I figure it'd be cool for you to listen to the whole worship service at my church, as it really kind of ties everything all together. If you want to just catch the message, you can pick that up at the 31-minute mark. So let us listen.
Thank you. Welcome. My name is Reverend Todd Laddick, and I'm the pastor here at First United Methodist Church of Newton, and I'm just so excited to be here this morning with you and to be worshiping with you and that you're tuning in. We are a church that loves all people and welcomes all people, and we would love nothing more than for you to continue to join with us as we worship together on Sunday mornings. Our reopening date is September 13th. We are planning to start to worship in person, and we will also be streaming live online. So the format online of worship will look a little different, a little less fancy, but we will be streaming live as we worship in person, so that those who are not comfortable with coming out or can't come out will still be able to join in with in worship with us. Today we're going to talk about what it takes to be the church in such times as the ones we find ourselves in. There are plenty of things that pull us in all different directions as the church, but we have a long history here in this world, one that started with biblical times with Jesus Christ and has carried on through the future. And our local church, just as I'm sure those of you who have local churches who are watching us from elsewhere, have had people invest their lives into it, have invested their blood, their sweat, their tears, their presence, their witness into the local faiths of community. And so we need to tell the world that no matter what it is you think you're going to compete with us, this house is not for sale. And with that, I welcome you to worship.
Good morning. Please join me responsively in the call to worship. The scriptures declare that God's house is a house of prayer. This house is not for sale. God's house is a sanctuary for all people. This house is not for sale. God's house is a house of justice, mercy, and humility. This house is not for sale. Amen. Now let us join together in singing our opening hymn, A Mighty Fortress is Our God.
Is our God a bulwark?
together as we pray our opening prayer. Lord, you have taught us to be diligent and to remain awake. You have warned us to not be deceived by false people and teachings. You have called us to be your temple and collectively to be your church. Dwell within us, that we may continue to build your house into an eternal kingdom on earth as it is in heaven. Breathe new life into us and steer us away from selling out to the world and its whims. Fill us with your Holy Spirit and guide us in your love. In Jesus Christ's name we pray. Amen.
Lord, I lift my friend to you. I've done all that I know to do. I lift my friend to you. Complicated circumstances have clouded his view. Lord, I lift my friend up to you. I fear that I won't have the words that he needs to hear. I pray for your wisdom, O God, and a heart that's sincere. And Lord, I lift my friend up to you. Lord, I lift my friend to you. My best friend in the world I know. She means much more to you. I want so much to help her, but this is something she has to do. Lord, I lift my friend up to you. There's a way that seems so right to her, but you know where that leads. She's becoming a puppet of the world, too blind to see the strings. And Lord, I lift my friend up to you.
It is our sacred duty and honor to be a people of prayer, and we are never, should we ever be short of praying for one another and praying for the church, praying for our government, praying for our world. That is what we as Christians do, even if we fall down on different sides in our worldviews or whatnot. The one thing that unites us together as Christians is our ability to pray for one another and to care for one another and to love one another as Jesus Christ taught us to do. So let us turn to our Lord in prayer. Gracious and loving God, we just thank you and praise you for creating us the church, for instituting the church and giving us the honor to work in building your kingdom up and expanding your house into the kingdom of heaven, which will be a home for all people when you return and you restore this world from what it is to what you have created it to be. Lord, help us to be a people who continually pray and lift one another up. There are plenty of people who are struggling in so many different ways, Lord, struggling in with addiction, struggling with financial problems, struggling in their health, struggling in their relationships with others and with you, people who are struggling emotionally, psychologically. We ask, Lord, that your healing hand be upon all people who are struggling, in particular the people who are suffering now because of a major hurricane which hit the Gulf Coast. Lord, for the victims of Hurricane Laura, we ask that your presence be with them, that your peace and assurance be with them, and that your healing be with them, not in spirit, just in spirit and in truth, but through the help of others who are going to sacrifice their time to help people recover. Lord, also for the people who are suffering racial and social injustice, we ask that your peace and assurance be with them, and that you would motivate us to be a people who do your work and do it for all people, not just for some. We ask that you make us peacemakers, and that you you lead us to raise our voices in solidarity with those who suffer the weight of oppression. But in all things, Lord, we thank you and we praise you, and we pray the prayer that you taught us to pray by praying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
Sunday school friends. The Bible tells us that when Jesus was living on earth, walking and talking with his friends and followers, people would come from all around to hear him speak. Jesus especially called the children to come to him. The crowds and the children loved having Jesus tell them stories. The stories that we call parables helped the people understand what Jesus was teaching them.
Jesus told this story about the wise man and the foolish man in his Sermon on the Mount. Once upon a time, Jesus said to the crowd, "Everyone who listens to my words and does what I tell them is like a wise man who built his house on solid rock."
"Ah," said the builder of the house on the rock, "I'm done building. Now I can enjoy my house that I worked so hard on."
Jesus continued, "But everyone who hears my words and does not obey them is like a foolish man who built his house on sand."
"Ah," said the builder of the house on the sand, "I always wanted a house right on the beach. Now I've got it. That guy has to walk all the way down to go to the beach. He's pretty far off from all the excitement. Wonder what he was thinking, huh?"
Uh-oh, suddenly a storm rose up. Both homeowners heard it coming, thunder in the distance and lightning on the horizon. The rain came down, the streams rose, and the winds blew and beat against the house.
"Oh no," said the builder of the house on the sand. "Now I get it why that guy built his house on the rock. His house is still standing. And mine is washing away."
"Wow, that poor guy," said the builder of the house on the rock. "That's a shame. He did not plan ahead for the things that can go wrong in life. He was thinking too much about the fun he could have."
The wise man's house did not fall because it had its foundation on the rock. The rain came down, the streams rose, and the wind blew and beat against the house. It stood strong, but the house on the sand fell with a great crash. What Jesus meant by this parable is to pay attention to God, trust in God. Don't be distracted by what other people like to do. If you keep what God wants you to do.
By now, you have already heard of the rock and roll band Bon Jovi. This band was started by a boy from our state of New Jersey. He has gone on to record many albums with his band and give concerts all around the world. Bon Jovi sings a song that reminds me of Jesus' parable about the wise man and the foolish man. That song is called, This House is Not for Sale. Well, I can see why this house is not for sale. What about Bon Jovi's house?
The first words of that song are, This house has a story to tell. We have learned that Jesus also had a story to tell. His story was about building a house. Let's jump to the middle of Bon Jovi's song, the part musicians call the bridge, as they sing a piece of their house's story. This house was built on trust. That's what it is and always was. Bon Jovi is singing about a house that sounds to me something like our church. In the Bible, God tells us in the book of Isaiah, my house shall be called a house of prayer for all people. Our church, God's house of prayer, was also built on trust. The people of our church trusted that God had always been with them. Even when they had been praying and worshiping in different church buildings, God still heard their prayers. This plate shows a picture of one of those early church buildings, right in the middle of Newton. So when God told his people that it was time for the church to move from that building again, the children of God prayed. And then, still trusting God, they left their beautiful, familiar church building that you saw in the plate. Some didn't want to go, but the trust in their hearts was firm, like a holy, solid rock. In the Bible, Psalm 78 says, and they remembered that God was their rock. So, as they moved toward their new building, the people of our church trusted God and trusted that he would be marching with them right down Main Street in Newton. And God did march with them to the place where we now pray together, our church. We trust that God is always with us wherever we go. That's what it is and always was. So you see, God's house also has a story to tell. Bon Jovi continues singing about their house's story. No wrecking ball could knock it down. This house was built on higher ground. When God's house of prayer holds the children of God, and when the church is built firmly on trust in God, that house, let me show you, that cannot be knocked down or knocked out or flooded by hard times and problems. A wrecking ball is a heavy, strong demolition machine, but it's not stronger than God. A wrecking ball is not stronger than the children of God who trust in him. A rainstorm with thunder and lightning and wind and flooding waters can be as strong as a wrecking ball. The foolish man in Jesus' parable discovered this. Peter, the fisherman and Jesus' disciple, felt the strength of the storm too, as he walked on the water toward Jesus. But Jesus can calm the scary storms as he calms our fears. And I think Jesus is calming these children's fears. A flooding storm is not stronger than the love that floods into our hearts from Jesus. The scary water cannot rise higher. Our hard times and worries are not higher than your trust in Jesus. And let's get those kids in there. He is our rock on the higher ground that Bon Jovi sings about. The firm rock that the wise man built his house upon. So don't let yourself be pulled away by what other people may do. Keep your eyes on Jesus, obey Jesus' words, then you will be able to build your house, your church, your thoughts, your actions, your words, your prayers, your whole life on Jesus. Then go and tell the world, this house is not for sale. I will stick with Jesus, and Jesus sticks with me. Let's pray. Dear God, we praise you for your love and strength. You are like a rock. We are thankful that we can trust that rock. In happy times and hard times, please help us to be like the wise man and build on you. In Jesus' name, we pray. Amen.
The scripture reading today is from 1 John chapter 2, verses 18 through 27. Dear children, the last hour is here. You have heard that the Antichrist is coming, and already many such Antichrists have appeared. From this we know that the last hour has come. These people left our churches, but they never really belonged with us, otherwise they would have stayed with us. When they left, it proved that they did not belong with us. But you are not like that, for the Holy One has given you his Spirit, and all of you know the truth. So I am writing to you not because you don't know the truth, but because you know the difference between truth and lies. And who is a liar? Anyone who says that Jesus is not the Christ, anyone who denies the Father and the Son is an Antichrist. Anyone who denies the Son doesn't have the Father either. But anyone who acknowledges the Son has the Father also. So you must remain faithful to what you have been taught from the beginning. If you do, you will remain in fellowship with the Son and with the Father, and in this fellowship we enjoy the eternal life he promised us. I am writing these things to warn you about those who want to lead you astray. But you have received the Holy Spirit, and he lives within you, so you don't need anyone to teach you what is true. For the Spirit teaches you everything you need to know, and what he teaches is true. It is not a lie. So just as he has taught you, remain in fellowship with Christ. This is the word of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God for this word.
Thank you. I've got a story to tell. The door is off the hinges, there's no wish in the well. Outside the sky is cold black and the streets are on fire. The picture window's cracked and there's nowhere to run. I know, this house is not for sale. I set each stone and I hammer each nail. This house is not for sale, where memories live and the dream don't fail. This house is not for sale. Coming home, I'm coming home. Drove a spike into the ground and staked my claim.
In a time when there are so many different things that are demanding our time, our effort, and our attention. Sports, work, politics, elections, and even the American dream are all in competition with our faith, and we find our communities and our society as a whole in a faith crisis. Friends, Christ instituted the church, and far too many people before us worked hard and even died to build this house for us to sell out now. This house is not for sale. In 2016, Bon Jovi released the eponymous song, This House Is Not For Sale, off the album of the same name. John got the idea of the song while flipping through a magazine. He saw a picture montage by renowned photographer Jerry Yulsman in a magazine. He saw that, and the picture was of a proud house, a proud old house that was founded on top of deep roots, that was in a state of disrepair. At the time, John was also personally selling one of his homes. And so the title, This House Is Not For Sale, came to mind in his head. The song itself uses the word house as a metaphor for the band. They had been through a lot since they were formed in 1984.
all of the naysayers that thought they would not make it past the 1980s were out and about throughout their entire career. In fact, once they got past the 80s, they weren't going to survive the 90s, then the 2000s hits, and they were big, and then there were the naysayers about them being in the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame, which only happened a couple of years ago. There were some bands that had formed long after them that ended up in the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame before them. They survived, again, the death of hair metal music caused by grunge music. And through the years, they had good times and they had bad times. In 2013, longtime friend and band member Richie Sambora left the band mid-tour, to focus on spending time with his daughter. And that's understandable, but the way he left was dramatic and shocking and hurtful to both the band and to fans. And Richie hasn't played with them except for when they were inducted into the Hall of Fame. He hasn't played with them since, other than that one time. Now, there was a period following that loss that John didn't even pick up his guitar or write new songs. Their record company, which they had been loyal to for over 30 years, was dropping them, and the future of the band was uncertain. So when John wrote the lyrics, "These four walls have a story to tell," he was referring to the four remaining members of the band. This song isn't about a literal house of brick and mortar. Rather, it was a song about the band members, about the family that they had become through thick and through thin, and how they weren't going to let the challenges and bumps in the road cause them to sell out or give up. Friends, while those lyrics were written about the band Bon Jovi, our many walls have a story to tell, too. Our church, our house, has a long story and history. Our story and history is told throughout the Bible. From biblical times, it continued through the millennia to our present time. We are individually and collectively a part of the Christian story. We have had many ups and also many downs. And so many people have invested their prayers, their presence, their gifts, their service, and their witness, sometimes their very lives, to make sure that the house continues to grow into the kingdom of God. Locally, First United Methodist Church of Newton, where I stand now, at its front door, the Sunday before we reopen after a long pandemic, this church, First United Methodist Church of Newton, also has a tremendous history and story to tell. And it is because of the countless people who carried its mission and ministry forward throughout the years. There was a time when our church was located right in the heart, right in the center of Newton on Park Place, next to the Newton Trust Building. But because of the bold, risky, and forward-looking vision that its members had at the time, our church moved to its current location under the leadership and guidance of Reverend E.T. Holland, and built a facility that would accommodate more people, would be easily accessible for differently abled people, and continue to serve the community and the mission of Jesus Christ in and around Newton and beyond to this day. We have the best parking lot in all of Newton because we moved to a place where there was ample land and we could give people place to park rather than having to risk parking on the road or utilizing other people's parking lot. We created an entryway that is easy for people to access the church, whether you can walk or not walk, whether you can walk well or you're not able to walk all that well. This church was built for people to worship in. It was built for people to serve God in. It was built for people to grow deeper in their faith in. Friends, this house is not for sale. In our scripture today, John was warning his faith community that the times they were going through were to be expected, and that they needed to remain resolute in their faith and commitment to Christ. It is in this scripture and other places in John's letters that we find the only instances of the word Antichrist used in the entire Bible. And the surrounding context defines exactly what was meant by that word. There were people who were leaving the churches in John's community and ultimately denying who Christ is. There were people, for varying reasons, abandoning their faith family, turning their backs on the people and the hard work and mission that had been done in Christ's name. In 1 John chapter 2, verses 20 through 21 and verse 24, John wrote to his current members, "But you are not like that, for the Holy One has given you his Spirit, and all of you know the truth. So I am writing to you not because you don't know the truth, but because you know the difference between truth and lies. So you must remain faithful to what you have been taught from the beginning. If you do, you will remain in fellowship with the Son and with the Father." In other words, sure, their church was in a bit of disrepair, but John was proclaiming, this house is not for sale. We're not going to kowtow to the naysayers. We're not going to buckle to society. We're not going to change the direction God is leading us in because people are leaving. We need to remain true to who we are and to who God created us to be. We need to remain true to the work, the mission, and the ministry of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Let me ask you these reflective questions. Why are you a person of faith? How high up is faith and spiritual disciplines, which maintain and grow our faith, on your list of priorities? In what ways have you been served by your faith community? In what ways have you served your faith community? And most importantly, what ways are you willing to step up even more to help support and push forward the mission and the ministry of the church? In what ways are you willing to contribute to the ongoing building of this house into God's kingdom throughout Newton and the surrounding areas and beyond? We need and desire to be in ministry with you. Friends, we are at a crossroads as the church, both globally, especially in Western civilization, and locally. We are either going to begin to rock out our faith in Jesus Christ, or we are going to hang up the guitar, so to speak, give up on this house that so many have shed their blood, sweat, and tears on, and abandon the faith. The choice is yours. The choice is mine. Will we sell out and become like the majority of people in our increasingly godless society and world? Or will we defiantly stand with our feet firmly in the mud and proclaim, this house is not for sale? It's our choice. It's our choice. May we choose wisely. Amen. Gracious and loving God, we thank you and praise you for this opportunity to be challenged by you. There's so much, Lord, that we could sell out on. There's so much that we could abandon and leave behind. But rock and roll is about grit and perseverance. Rock and roll is about knowing who we are founded on and carrying forward despite the stuff around us. Rock and roll is rebellious against the culture and the status quo. It is innovative. It is revolutionary. It is Jesus Christ. Help us to rock out our faith in Christ so that we can not only survive these days, but that we will thrive and be transformative in them. So that we will not only be living on a prayer, but we'll be keeping the faith. And so that we will show the world that Jesus Christ is here and here to stay, and this house is not for sale. We pray all of these things in Jesus Christ, our Lord and our Savior. Amen. Friends, the work of Jesus Christ is being done here at Newton, at First United Methodist Church of Newton. It's being done here in the Newton community and beyond by faithful people such as yourself. And the way in which we're able to be a part of the mission and ministry is through our prayers, it's through our presence, it's through our service, it's through our witness, and it's also through our gifts. It is our distinct honor and privilege to be able to give back to God what God has given to us joyfully out of a joyful heart so that the ministry and the mission of the church can affect lives and bring transformation into this world in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord and our Savior. And so I would like to invite you to give. You can give online via the links in the description or the links in the chat to the side, the live chat. You can also mail in your checks and write and make them out and mail them to First United Methodist Church of Newton, 111 Ryerson, R-Y-E-R-S-O-N, Avenue, Newton, New Jersey, 07860. But with all of your heart, give as the Holy Spirit is calling you to.
And now let us pray our prayer of dedication. Everlasting God, these gifts are given with joyful and willing hearts. Bless them and use them for the work of your kingdom. Bless others with these gifts so that they may come to know and love you. Bless us as well, so that we may be an ever-increasing blessing to others. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Now please close your eyes and meditate on the words of our closing song, Battle Hymn of the Republic.
May the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious unto you. May the Lord lift up his countenance upon you and give you peace. May the Lord fill your heart with courage and boldness. May the Lord fill your heart with the desire and the passion to serve others and to be a witness for Jesus Christ. May the Lord put in your heart the desire to continue to build upon the foundation of Jesus Christ and the others who have followed him, so that our church may grow from just a house to the kingdom of God in all of the world. And do all of this in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.